Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the very first time, thanks so much for stopping by. If you're returning, thumbs up to you. Today I'm gonna show you how you can create an animated Instagram story using Adobe Express Beta. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here at the new homepage of Adobe Express Beta, I'm going to create this animated Instagram story graphic. And I'm going to click right here to photo. And just to show you, if you scroll through here, you have templates. You can start from Adobe stock photos and so on. You have your AI text to image and text effects and so on. But we're going to choose to start from a photo. I have a photo that I'm going to bring in here, and we're going to add text and we're going to add some animation to that text. So let's go ahead and bring in that photo. I'm going to go ahead and find the photo that we'll use. Here it is. I'm going to bring in this photo. I'm going to use that. So we'll click on create new. And for this, I'm going to choose Instagram story, because that's what we're going to create. And so first thing we'll do here is make some adjustment to the photo here. So I'm going to drag this right here to fill it. And of course, the photo that I took, it's a little larger than the Instagram story format. So actually what I could do is click right here with this crop and then choose the story 9x16 and it'll crop it just right. And then what I'll go ahead and do is just make some adjustment to the photo here. And so let's go ahead and resize this, make this a little bit larger. I really want to avoid some of that wall space up there on my photo, right about, I think that'll be perfect right about there. Maybe move it over a bit. So I think that will be just fine. And then we'll just fill this up right here. I think that'll be good. So what I want to do is use this space over here. So I may do a little bit of a crop adjustment, move my face over a bit right about there, and maybe a little bit more. So there we go. And click out here. So perfect. We're going to use this area here for that animated graphic. So what we're going to do is click on add your text here. I'm going to go ahead and move that up right about there. It's all selected. I've already got my text ready to go. Let's go ahead and select that. We'll make some adjustments to that text. And I'm going to come over here to the left to the menu option and choose dynamic. And with it all selected, I'm going to choose my favorite font, which is Betaress Nuevo. There we go. We've got this one here that I just love to use. I'm going to make some adjustment to the text spacing right here. Bring that right about there. And I think that'll work just fine. We're going to change the text color to white and right here. So this is going to be our text and just a little bit small right about there. And then what I'm going to do next is add a shape kind of in the background that's going to serve as kind of a highlight option. And so what I'll do here on the left hand column is choose elements, and you have design assets, backgrounds, and shapes. And so right here in the shapes, what I'm going to do is choose, let's type in triangle. Let's see what type of triangle shapes I'll get. Hit enter. And let's see here. Well, maybe I don't like any of those. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and go with a maybe a rectangle here. So we'll put the rectangle. And because this has been added after the text, the rectangle will be above that layer. So what I'm going to do here is over on the right-hand side, you can see the stack right here. I will just drag that beneath the text. So now the text is in front. And I'm going to just offset this a bit, make that a little bit smaller as well. And let's see here. We're going to go ahead and use the arrow keys to bring that down. See if it'll work. Nope. Let's do this. Here we go. We'll move this down. All right. So I've got my text and I've got the box behind it. I'm going to change the color of that box just so it's a little more visible. And I'm going to go with a light blue right about right there. I think that works just fine. Maybe let's see, let's do grab a color from my photo here. I like this bluish tone over here, so let's see. There we go. Maybe go a little bit lighter on that, take advantage of the custom menu option right here. I think that'll work just fine for this. Now what I'm going to do for this animated option to make this animated is right now it's a static image. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this box right now and choose the animation option down here at the bottom. So we're going to have this come in and we're going to give it again an animation. So all these different ones. Ah, that one looks pretty cool. I like that pop. We're going to pop that, and then we're going to leave that there, and maybe do a maybe we'll have it fade out. Well, let's see. Yeah, I think we'll have it fade out. And so now what I'll do is I'll select that shape. Let's go ahead and scroll through here. We'll select that shape, and we're going to make sure and choose the layering so that we can see that, because I don't want that to show up to the entire project. So we'll do this. We're going to slide that right about there. My scene right now, let's see here, it's a 5-second clip. So if I go ahead and hit play, it'll come through and then fade out. Maybe that was a little too fast. So let's go ahead and increase that. All right, maybe we'll do 3.5 seconds. We'll put it right about there. And then now we'll hover over. And so I've got my text, and I'm going to select the text. We're going to do the same thing for text. We're going to animate that text. So here we go, animation in. So right now the text is kind of, I would say, fading or popping down. So the other one kind of pops in. So I think what I want to do for the text is I want the text to kind of have the same type of pop. There we go. We're going to have it pop as well. And then I think we'll have it also fade out so it matches the other. And now what I need to do is make an adjustment to the time when it rolls in. So as you can see, right about there is where the box appears. So that should be the same time for both. All right, there. Now I could do this. I can make my text actually come after that. So the box will pop in and then the text will pop in. And that's actually looks pretty cool. And then so we'll go ahead and scroll through and it fades out. And so we'll make our text fade out kind of along the same line. So let's see, let's hit play. And boom, there we have it. And then fades out. So really cool way to animate text in Adobe Express Beta, make it animated, get this Instagram graphic. Now what I could do here is take these two and let's see, we'll select them both. If we don't want that, we'll select, let's see here. We've got both of these selected so we can group these. So now let's see how the project plays out. Let's click on play here. And there we go, it pops in and then it fades out. Maybe make a tiny adjustment, maybe have it fade in a little bit earlier or pop in a little earlier. So let's see here, so there's not too much empty space. Play, boom, that comes in. Yeah, that's just about right. I'll go ahead and stop. And if you want to, you can add additional scenes or you can extend this. I think I would just go ahead and maybe duplicate this scene here. So we'll hit duplicate. And then if I scroll through, here we go. Look at that. Now I've got the same exact animation. So if you wanted to create a multiple animated graphic that you share on Instagram, you can just go up here and then type in the text box right there. And now you can select it all and type it in. I should say select all. There we go. And then type in a new message. And basically you have the same format. Might make to make some slight adjustment to the text box just because it's a different amount of text that's showing up. Slightly move it, and then here we go. So now we have that going through, fades out, and then it comes to the next scene. There's a little too much space there, but I can make that adjustment. But as you can see, you can continue, just duplicate, and then change the text, and you can go as many scenes as you want. Once you're ready to share on social, click on download. And since this is going to be an animated graphic, just leave it right there for video. Leave it at 1080. And then go ahead and download, and you're ready to share on social media.
So now it's your turn to create animated Instagram story graphics using Adobe Express Beta. If you have any comments or questions about the video, feel free to drop it into the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for your future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by, and until next time, have fun creating.
Peace.